Hello, everybody. It is 6:45 p.m. Central Time on the 25th of June, 2020. It sounds like I'm in an echo chamber because really I am. I'm in an empty office here in the middle of moving, and we've got ourselves a big-time earthquake activity. So, again, sorry if it sounds a little echoey. Can't do anything about that right now, but we're here to talk about seismic events. I don't think it really matters that much, does it? Okay, so let's turn on display capture and just go show you what happened. A new 6.4 earthquake and swarm has broken out here in the Himalayan range in western China, just south of the Taklamakan Desert, which is right here where the tip of the arrow is. And this is on top of the other 6.0 level activity, or, well, 5.9, 5.9, and 5.9, which actually, this was a 6.2 reported by the Japanese. I trust the Japanese reporting of earthquakes, don't you guys? Maybe even a little bit more than the USGS, wouldn't you say? Okay, well, 5.9, 5.9 back down at Guam, and a 5.9 back down here, down in the, well, I guess South Central Pacific. And then, of course, mid-range 5 hit down here in South New Zealand, and 4 level activity. That all happened yesterday. And then today, boom, new mid-range 6 popping here. New 5.0 level activity going across the Indian Ocean. New 5.0 level activity coming in between the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea. This is the Black Sea on the western side. This is the Caspian Sea on the eastern side. We're in south, I guess, Ukraine, eastern Turkey. And we go over to the west and we have new mid-range 4 level activity in Romania. And we go up to the north. We're in Poland. We also have activity. It's a big spread. Also, even Western Africa over here at Ghana. This is not a 0.0 range earthquake at the coordinates. This is actually an earthquake in Ghana. I went and looked it up, and it's next to a concrete factory. But it's deep down in the crust. Maybe it's one of those bases everybody's been talking about. Well, anyway, we go back over here, and this big earthquake struck in China. Let's go pull the coordinates on it and go see Hotan, China, okay? 10-kilometer auto-generated depth. They have not bothered to refine the depth on this. I would say it's probably shallow because there were a lot of felt reports in China made the news. So it's not a deep earthquake far down below the area. I guess that's good, right? Okay, what's this place? Chungmutska the First or One? That's the name of the peak there. I've never heard of that before. There's... okay, I'm not going to even try to pronounce that. Here's the Taklamakan Desert here. And, well, let's back it out. Oh, wait, hold on. Hold on. We've got a Smithsonian. The Kunlun Volcanic Group in northwest Tibet contains 70 well-preserved pyroclastic cones. The Trachiniandesitic Ashkul Volcano Group at the western end of the Kunlun Mountains is the site of at least 10 volcanoes of Pleistocene to Holocene age. Wow, there's like 80 volcanoes across here. One range away. Let's get a measurement on that. Just see how far. I know it's, you know, further than... Oh, wait. Hold on. Took a minute for this to populate. Or maybe I just missed it. Unnamed. Quaternary volcano. From the International Volcano whatever, 1973. Well, we see the lava flow here. Wow, this is old. Look at this, guys. This is amazing. Now, of course, the imagery is so low res, but even with low res imagery, you can see they have these like salt type lakes that have formed in there from, I guess, snow melting and mineral deposits. It's barren, and it's, of course, a large volcano. Let's get a measurement across how big this thing is. It's unnamed. I guess we can name it, right? 15 miles across. Well, if it's unnamed, but it has been discovered, I guess I need to go there and plant my flag on it. Go put the Dutch Sense flag on there. They do sell that in the Dutch Sense shop, by the way. It's more like a tapestry on one side, but what's the difference? So how far are we exactly from the earthquake? I need to see that. I always try to get it within 40 miles of a volcano. If there is one, 20 miles to the center, 28 miles to the center of this. So, I mean, come on, we are definitely right next to a volcano. We're east of a large volcanic group, and we have an unnamed from an earlier time period. That's going back to the Ice Age and beyond, a long time ago. So, okay, that changes everything, doesn't it? I mean, it's not like it's just an earthquake right across our arrow or on the Himalayan range. It's next to an ancient volcano going back tens of thousands of years, if not more. and it's swarming within 20 miles and or 28 miles. And the reason I look within 40 miles is magma chambers can shift over time. As the plates are kind of staying somewhat in the same place, maybe rolling over on themselves, the magma chambers tend to shift, kind of like Hawaii. Think of Hawaii, you got that magma chamber shifting underneath. They tell us that the plate is shifting? No. But anyway, so there we go. It's pretty much a slam dunk. It's next to the volcanoes there, and it's right along where we would expect a progression to happen. Now, we trace this back, and you can see it. Well, maybe you can't. Let me show you the smaller and larger earthquakes. Here's our 5.9 and greater. So it's like a dividing line across the whole West Pacific, spreading out to the Indian Ocean, and it's all pretty much the same size, mid-range to upper 5, within the middle of this, where our 6 is. Now, this goes back to here, where we had our big, deep earthquake. You got to go back to the start of this week, and we had a 7.4 earthquake down here in New Zealand, or, well, just north of New Zealand. And then up here to the north by northeast of the Pacific, of course, we have our 7.4 that came in here on the coast of Mexico, and a new near 6.0 earthquake, which struck next to the volcanoes here at Lone Pine, the Big Pine Volcanic Field, or just north of Kozo, or just east of Templeton Mountain Volcano. So that is just a heck of a lot of activity, and that's just the tip of the iceberg. That's just the big earthquake activity in the last day. We have our deep earthquakes that have popped off here on our letter D, again, a new set of deep earthquakes. And when deep earthquakes happen, that's a push on the underside of the plate. It can cause a new round to develop. And if we see more of these, so this letter D has been hit, are we going to see new deep earthquakes here on these two? Or up here at Japan? Or up here at the Sea of Okhotsk? Or over here in the Middle East? Or in South America? I mean, is it going to light up again like it did last week? Because last week, this all lit up with deep earthquakes, which led me to issue the warning for 7.0 plus activity. And then we see two sevens, a bunch of sixes, a bunch of fives spreading out across the planet, out and away from where that big deep earthquake happened. And that big deep earthquake was here on the Izu Ridge, south of Japan. We're not done yet, I don't think. It's starting to creep north. I mean, you can see it going to the north. I mean, how about the coast of Tokyo getting hit with a 6? 6.2. Tokyo was our warned area. I issued specific warnings 7 days ago or 8 days ago, just about a week ago. We talked about Tokyo. Let's go see how far we are from Tokyo. I do need to know. So if I warn for 6.0 level activity and a new 6.2 comes in, USGS puts it at 5.9 because of their funny business. Come on. We've got to go measure it and see how far we are off from Tokyo. Because it's not like Tokyo gets hit every day, or every week, or every month. Okay, there's Tokyo right here, and we're going to measure from the earthquake. And we're going to measure over to Tokyo. 80 miles, 83 miles to the center of downtown Tokyo, or you could say this is eastern Tokyo, 70 miles to 80 miles off. And I try to get it within 200 miles. So if I'm 70 miles off, that's a direct earthquake forecast hit on something that every professional, and a lot of other people too, said was impossible. Now, speaking of impossible, they also said, the professional said, there was no progression of earthquakes going across the North American craton, or any other craton for that matter. But yet, we have now seen a progression go across the edge of the craton at two different pumping operations. Oklahoma at the Kansas border, and down at the south tip, down in Alabama. And I went and looked these up earlier, so but they're two of the same sized earthquakes, 2.9, 2.9, or a 3.1 and a 2.9. Either way, they're two of the same sized earthquakes. Do I need to show you the pumping operations? I mean, I can. It takes extra time, and it's something that's rather trivial to me, but to a lot of people, well, they were having a hard time accepting that pumping operations were getting hit for some reason. They were failing to understand that if you perforate or drill into something a whole bunch of times, that it can weaken it. They didn't understand that, apparently. Or somebody didn't understand that because they were in full denial about there being any relation between the oil pumping operations and the earthquake striking right next to them. So let's just go show you an example right here in the middle of this field. A couple tanks, pipeline, burn apparatus, and the shadow of a jack or a pump in the middle of the field. And that's just one. You see how small that is, right? Across the road. What do we got across the road? Pipeline. What's this? Another one. Tank, berm, pipeline. I don't see the jack in this one, in this field. Where are they creating the pressure from for that one? Well, we'll have to go around and find it. You'll find a nearby jack or a pump. You'll find the tanks, and you'll find the drill points, but they'll create leverage and pressure from different jacks and pumps spread out across the area. So we can just keep going and looking. If you guys want to, you can do that. But that just runs home the point. The earthquake is right next to the pumping operation drill point. So Alabama. Come on, Alabama. Barry, Alabama. Well, we're going to the Deep South. Come on, y'all. Hey, I'm from Missouri. Come on, I can say that. We're right at the dividing line between where you can say y'all and you can't. Okay. So here we are. And there we are. So now you're going to see I have some place marks nearby from previous earthquakes which struck. This is 8 miles. I measured this earlier. 8.3 miles from here down to all of these little specks. And every little speck is a point where they've drilled or plan to drill. And just zooming in on one of them here, you'll see the shadow of the jack. Whoops. You'll see the shadow of the jack there. This is Alabama now. Now, I don't know about these. Have they already done these, or they just flatten them out for exploration? Those have not been drilled yet as of 2019, but these have. So they're carrying it north. I mean, we can pretty much guarantee that. And the earthquake is 8 miles. I always look within 6 to 10 miles. The reason I look within 6 to 10 miles, one, the imagery can be old. 2020, they could have gotten out here and done more drilling. Or two, they can drill at an angle by several miles. So this pad could go at an angle by several miles. Then we're just a couple miles from the actual earthquake epicenter. So two of the same-sized earthquakes at drill points, both on the edge of the North American Craton, both in the same day, and that follows our 4-point-something activity over to the west. Well, look. So, since our big earthquake down in California, we saw one follow-up aftershock of significant size. Look at the size. 4.6, right? That's the biggest. Why does that matter? Because there's another 4.6 up on the northwest edge of the Craton, up in Idaho, that struck last night. I saw an influx of a few hundred people last night, late night, and I said, what's going on? And then people were like, dude, I'm in Idaho. I just felt shaking. Then ding, mid-range 4 pops in here on the feed, right above the deepest part of the magma chamber for Yellowstone. Now, Yellowstone's at the Wyoming border with Idaho, over here, at the surface. But it actually has a magma chamber that goes down and at an angle down below all of Idaho, overreaching over to Oregon's border. 11 Grand Canyons in size, going down 30 kilometers at an angle, putting the center of the deepest part of the feeder of the magma chamber right here in Idaho. Now, about 60 or 70 miles away from this location, a man was out walking with his dogs back in 2015 after a 5-point-something earthquake struck in this general area here in central Idaho in the Challis Reserve. And the place is called, let's see, the... Oh boy, I can't remember the name of the spring that got overheated, but he would normally go and swim in it as a temperate spring with his dogs. And they went up there, the dogs jumped in, and it wasn't temperate. After the earthquake, something had shifted and allowed for more heat to come up. The professionals and mainstream media came out with cover stories for what happened, and they said that, oh, it just must be a lack of cold water flowing into the stream, which feeds it, and he just must not have known, and it was just crazy. Meanwhile, the earthquake swarm is happening, and we've got a bunch of volcanoes right here. Black Butte Crater, Craters of the Moon Volcanic Center, and when I did the radiation measurements after the Japan earthquake back in 2011, drove across the entire United States taking radiation readings because the EPA turned off their radiation monitoring sites. I got Geiger counters and drove from the East Coast to the West Coast. Anyway, stopped here along the way. Pulled into the park right here. Nobody there. Just a ranger and a few people. And this is the campground. And I got a camp right there. Took radiation readings too. Those are on my Dutch Sense backup channel if you want to see those. But so I've been right here and these volcanoes are huge. And they're fed by the greater magma chamber down below that feeds Yellowstone. And they all just put this together in the last few years when they did the new Earth-penetrating tomography measurements. VLF, basically, very low frequency. They bounce down into the crust, and it bounces back like an image almost. and it tells them what's down in there or how big, so forth. And they found out it's 11 Grand Canyons in size and reaches over to here. So we get two 4.6s, and this 4.6 to the south, down here next to Lone Pine, the earthquake struck right in here, in the lowest point in this Death Valley-type location. And I showed this yesterday, but here, let me turn all these off so you can see this a little bit better. There we go. So this I showed yesterday, it's 3/4 of a crescent shape, which actually fulfills a full oval shape if you include this bulging laccolith or bulge in the plate here. And the rest of these are marked volcanoes. Golden Trout Creek, Red Hill, two of the same size and shape. This one's younger, of course. Golden Trout Creek, and right next to it, right down the valley, same size and shape, Red Hill. And then down here, Templeton Mountain here, and Monash Mountain here. Again, two of the same size and shape volcanoes. So there's four, one, two, three, four, and then of course Brown Mountain. We connect over to Soda Butte here, which gets its name from effervescence in the water and bubbling in the water. So this giant oval shape is the same size and shape as Long Valley Caldera is up here, the confirmed supervolcano with 240 cubic miles of melt or 1,000 cubic kilometers down below. This, notice, again, they're the same size and shape. Both are lined with volcanoes. One's marked as a supervolcano. The other is not. The earthquake coming in right next to it. Why am I making a big deal about it? 4.6 on top of the 5.8 to 6.0 earthquake, and a 4.6 above the magma chamber for Yellowstone, both in the same 24-hour time period. Spread of earthquakes going across the Craton one more time, going over to the Midwest and over to the East Coast. And South America, let's just quickly touch on this, a spread going south of Easter Island. And let me see if I can find the speck of a dot of Easter Island out. Easter Island region. Ah, here it is. Good eye. It's a splotch on the map. That's Easter Island, but our arrow, you can see, traces back to where our deep earthquakes are. And same-sized earthquake that struck here, pretty much struck over here. 5.2, mid-range 5. And then, to top it all off, USGS with the 4.9. Funny business. Letter X was hit by a 5. Whatever. They took it down to a 4.9. People messaging me from Puerto Rico saying thank you, and people messaging me from Haiti, Dominican Republic area. I think Dominican Republic is where they measured from. Well, they got hit yesterday, one day after we issued the warning. What are you getting? What do you know? 4.6. So it sure seems to be a lot of 4.6s mixed in between our 5s and our 6s. It's the same spread going across the whole planet at this point. So it's been a busy week. Let's just recap. Mid-range 6 is struck here right next to an unnamed Pleistocene Ice Age volcano in China. A spread of earthquakes going across Europe, reaching out towards Poland. Spread of earthquakes going down across the Indian Ocean, spreading out from our centralized area. Indonesia's gone high and dry. That's not good. Let me just tell you, when we see Indonesia go quiet, that's when I watch Indonesia for larger earthquake activity. The longer we go, the worse it could be. So I would hope that we would see new 5.0 level activity here right in the middle of the area next to East Timor. In case you don't know your geography, this is East Timor and this is Bali. I would look pretty much right in the middle of this area for a new release to happen, hopefully in the 5 level. If it goes any more than that, please do not fault me, no pun intended, but really, seriously, we need to watch the middle of that area. West coast of the United States, man, I'll tell you what, we are again quiet, and I think this is artificially induced quietness. I think that, in layman's terms, would mean that they're not reporting earthquakes. I don't know, it just seems like it. I mean, we get a bunch of fours down here on the coast. It's high and dry here for the whole time. They're not reporting earthquakes, come on. And now that I said something, they're going to go freak out and do their little thing and whatever they got to go. Okay, do you have an earthquake plan? This is just a brief update. I'm not doing a full one-hour update. I'm in the middle of an empty office, and my voice is echoing. It's starting to really annoy me. So let me just tell you, you need to have an earthquake plan. I'll do a full update tomorrow, hour-long. We'll go look up every single location. We'll do a new forecast as well, telling people areas to watch. But I'll just tell you right now, this has gone quiet. We need to watch the middle of this area, the fulcrum point of this area. Now that a new 6 is struck in China, we have to warn the people here. This is Iran at the Iraq border. So Western Iran is going to be due for 6.0 level activity. Now that new 5s have struck here at Turkey, we have to warn Greece. Central Greece going over to the west, Western Greece, south of Italy, and it should be in the 5 level as well. Let's just put it to 5.3 to 5.4. So it's going to get busy across South Europe. Then, following that, that's why I have to do another video probably tomorrow or something, it's going to go across Europe and we're going to have a new spread. Look, it's spreading. It's spreading from the West Pacific. Even a kid could see it. It's gone out and across. It's going out in all directions. The spots that are the middle point should get filled in. Here's another spot that we have to watch. See where the two sets of rings overlap? It's almost perfect. Like a two-arm scale. Got a 5.8 and a bunch of earthquakes on one side, 5.4 and a bunch of earthquakes and a few eruptions on the other. So like a two-arm scale, it's almost equally weighted. But look where it overlaps on the plate boundary. South Baja. South to central Baja, California, Mexico. That's the warned area that I talked about in yesterday's update. To say to watch for new 6.0 level activity. We're not done yet. New deep earthquakes have just popped off again, which means we're about to go through this again. If any more than this takes place, we're going to go through it again. So let's hope, and I'm for hoping, you know, hope in science. Come on, man. It's like a belief, you know, but we need to hope that this just dies out. Because right now, it looks like it's gone back through the planet. It looks like the reverberation is happening. The feedback loop. My longtime viewers understand this. It's almost like a feedback loop in an audio device. So when a microphone picks up a sound too close to the speaker, puts it back through the system, comes back out, goes back through the system, increases in amplitude. Eventually your speaker will blow if you don't take care of that feedback. Well, the feedback loop on the Earth goes through the planet and comes back out. Sometimes, if the push is great enough. And obviously, the push was great enough this past time. It was right here. Right here. So a big push came up underneath here to start the whole thing. It's not done yet. It looks like it's coming back around again. And when it comes back around again, it feeds back into itself. Till a big thing releases. Till a big earthquake hits. Then that seems to be the release that spreads it out. So the feedback loop happens till it gets to a crescendo. Then, just like a speaker blowing, you get yourself the big mega quake that hardly ever happens. I don't think that's going to happen yet, but it's going back through the second time for sure. And that's what we're dealing with now. This is a good time for me to save as a video and put to YouTube for people to watch back. Even though it's just an impromptu update, even though I'm echoing in the background, people need to see this. This is the next mid-range 6. How many are we going to have? We just had 3 5.9s, 6s, plus the 2 7.4s, now swarms of 6s? Somebody needs to pay attention to this aside from me, professional-wise, I mean. But anyways, that's why I'm doing so well online. Thank you to everybody who subscribed. Please subscribe to my channel. Get the word out however you can. You can even leave my name out of it if you need to. You can just tell the people you heard. But, you know, telling somebody you heard something online. Yeah, I don't know if you want to do that. Maybe you should just tell them to watch and they can see the reasoning behind why I'm telling people where to watch. And let them decide for themselves. good luck with that, too. All right, guys. Peace out, word up, and much love.